One of the things I've become pretty good at over the years is helping people organize different aspects of their digital data, whether we're talking about photos, music, emails, documents, etc. 7 months ago, I devised an easy-to-follow workflow that made organizing your documents incredibly straightforward. Since then, I have significantly refined the workflow, taking it to a brand new level. So if your documents folder is a hot mess, then this tutorial is for you. That's coming up next on Tech Talk America. Hey folks, and welcome to the class. Before we dive in, let me give you an idea of how this works. We're going to treat your documents folder like we're renovating a closet. And what's the first thing you have to do anytime you renovate? You have to start by clearing everything out and putting it into temporary storage. Then we're going to install a pre-assembled, highly organized folder structure into your documents folder so everything has a place to live. Think of it as California closets for your documents. Finally, we'll migrate your data back into that structure. First, I want you to create a folder on your desktop called To Be Organized. Now, I want you to take all of the files on your desktop, everything that's in your documents folder, and maybe the contents of your downloads folder, and move everything into this folder. At this point, you can either spend the next 2 hours creating something that mildly resembles the folder structure that I'm about to show you, or for the cost of one cocktail, you can buy it pre-assembled from my website and be up and running in minutes. To do so, pop over to my website at techtalkamerica.com, and here on the homepage, scroll down and click on the Buy Now button. After you've completed the payment, don't close the window because then it will redirect you to WeTransfer. From here, click the I Agree button at the bottom left, and then click Download. At this point, you'll want to go into your Downloads folder, double-click on the Organized Documents folder, select all of the contents, and move everything into your Documents folder. At this point, let's take a look at this folder structure. You'll notice that some of these folders have a red tag next to them. Red tagged folders are designed to be shared with others. For example, there's a folder called Family Shared, where you can store important files like family recipes, marriage certificates, medical records, power of attorney, and more. To share a folder with a family member, just click on the folder and then click the Share button at the top. That's the one that looks like a box with an arrow coming out of it. And I recommend that you send access via email. For those of you who have pets or kids, you'll also notice that there are shared folders for babysitters and pet sitters. And if we go into those folders, you'll find a simple form that you can fill out that contains all of the important information a babysitter or pet sitter might need in case of an emergency. One of the things you should know is these folders are multiple levels deep. For example, this is what the business folder looks like. And as you can see, there truly is a place for everything. If you go to church, there are folders for everything from confirmation documents to sacred texts. If you're a student or teacher, there is a folder dedicated to education. At this point, I'd like to go over one of the major new features that was not available the last time I taught this class. You may have noticed that one of the folders is called Find My Stuff. If you've watched my videos over the years, we've talked in the past about smart albums, smart mailboxes, and smart playlists. But somehow we've never talked about smart folders. A smart folder is basically an intelligent search. You give it terms and conditions, and then it finds every single file that matches those terms and conditions. Before we proceed any further, I do strongly recommend that you open a Finder window, then go into the View menu and make sure that it is set to display the path. That way you can see where these files actually live at the bottom of the window. So let's say you've got documents that are hiding in other locations that we have not considered. For example, let's say you have an important PDF that you just can't find. This smart folder will find every single PDF on your hard drive. These smart folders can also help locate large files that you might not need anymore. The All Movies smart folder, for example, will find every single video file on your hard drive. When I did this on my computer, one of the surprises was I discovered duplicate files of every single movie I had ever purchased through iTunes. So not only will this smart folder help you get organized, it may also help reveal hidden junk that is unnecessarily taking up space on your hard drive. Speaking of junk, another smart folder I'd like to bring to your attention is old iPhone apps. Long story short, back in the early days of the iPhone, apps that you downloaded on your phone would be automatically backed up to your computer via iTunes. And if you're one of those people who has migrated your data from Mac to Mac over the years, there's a really good chance that those ancient files are still hiding on your hard drive and taking up space. The next few tricks I'd like to teach you will help you move files from the to-be-organized folder back into the appropriate place. What I recommend you do is open two Finder windows next to each other, one set to the Documents folder and the other to the To Be Organized folder. Now, hover your cursor over the green dot to reveal the option for split screen mode. I'll move this window to the left, and now I can click on this window to move it to the right. For this process, I think you'll find it most helpful if you set the To Be Organized folder into List View, which you can achieve by pressing Command 2, and the Documents folder I'd set to Column View, which is Command 3. Now, all you need to do is drag the files from the left into the appropriate folders on the right. Keep in mind, if you need any further assistance with this process, or if you have other questions about your Mac, iPad, or iPhone, you can work with me remotely from the comfort and privacy of your own home. To book a session, please visit my website at techtalkamerica.com. Don't forget to click the like button, and thanks for watching. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.